Hi everyone, I am Dr. Bharat Vijay Purohit. I am director and head of the department cardiology in Care Hospital, Dhai Tech City. I will be talking about what to do when you are suspecting a patient to be having a heart attack. Now, heart attack, as I told, is a serious situation. It's an emergency and patient can die immediately. So and so that we have found that 25% of heart attack people, they do not even reach the hospital. That means the disease is so dangerous that patient may just collapse and it will be difficult to take them to hospital, or by the time you reach hospital, the things might be delayed. Now, why does it happen like that? The issue is the heart attack happens when the blood clots inside the blood circulation, which is supplying the heart muscles, which we call as a coronary artery. So if there is a blood clotting inside the coronary artery, then immediately that portion of the heart muscle will not get any blood supply and it will start dying. So we have three blood supply which are mainly supplying the heart. On the left side, we have two, left anterior descending and left circumflex artery. And on the right side, we have one which is called a right coronary artery. Where there may be some minor variations also here and there, but these are the three main blood circulation supplying the heart. And depending on the area where the blood clots, you get the severity of the heart attack depending on that. Now, why does this clotting happens? Because when you have a blockage, whether it may be 10% or a 20% or a 30%, that means your artery is having a cholesterol deposit. Now, this cholesterol which is deposited in the artery is protected from the blood which is flowing through the artery by a thin layer which is called as an endothelium. So, if you have a pipe like this through which the blood is flowing, in this there is a lining, protective lining is there, which is called as an endothelium, and the cholesterol deposits below it. So, the blood doesn't come in contact with the cholesterol. But if the lining is thin, then because of some issue, whether it is stress or because of sudden surge in high BP or any other reason, if that lining breaks at any point of time, then the underlying material will be exposed to the blood, and immediately when the blood comes in contact with something which is foreign to it, immediately the coagulation factor gets activated and the blood clots. Now, you know, for clotting of a blood, it takes only 2 or 3 minutes, and that's the reason why heart attack is so sudden. People come and tell us, "Doctor, I was absolutely fine in the morning. I did all my activity. I went to the meeting. Everything was fine. But suddenly I got heart attack. How can it happen so suddenly? I did not have." So this is the reason. The lining was absolutely intact till that time. And suddenly when the lining broke, the blood clotted, which took only 2 to 3 minutes, and you got a sudden discomfort. Now, when you have a heart attack like symptoms, there may be a chest pain, there may be heaviness, there may be sudden squeezing sensation, or there may be sudden breathing difficulty that you will feel suffocated, you will feel breathless, and or these symptoms will be in the central area of the chest. It is very unlikely that someone is having exact pinpointing pain in one area or the right side or the left side or some pin pricking sensation. Generally, these are not heart related symptoms, and these symptoms may be confined to the central area of the chest, or it may radiate to the left arm or to the right arm or to the jaw area, or it may go even up to the umbilical area, but not below the umbilicus. Some people can present like vomiting or burning in the chest also, which is confused with acidity. So if somebody has any of these symptoms, sweating may be there, may not be there, because it is a sign of pain or a discomfort. If you have severe discomfort, you may have set in, and there are people who may not have it also. Now, when you suspect that anybody is having any of these symptoms and you suspect it's a heart attack, the first thing which needs to be done is to give absolute rest to the patient. You need not panic, you need not run around, you immediately give a call to your friend immediately and try to arrange a 3-wheeler or a 4-wheeler in which, with absolute rest, you need to reach the hospital. The least you can do is make sure that the patient do not walk much. There is no need, because in the WhatsApp or social media, I hear about this wonder pill and all this thing. But unless and otherwise you have a diagnosis, if you take those pills also may give rise to harm in some situation, because they contain blood thinners. And if you have some other issue like an acidity or a stomach perforation and you have taken all those things, you are just adding more problem to you. So reach the immediate hospital, whichever is the nearest, get an ECG done, get a 2D echo done, some blood test may be done. So all this will tell immediately whether you have a heart attack or not. And once they have diagnosed a heart attack, the first thing which will be done is to give you blood thinner so that the clot doesn't propagate further. These are called antiplatelet drug. Once you have been given antiplatelet like an aspirin or a ticagrelor or a prasugrel, then they will do treatment to dissolve the clot which is there. And all this will happen rapidly because every second is important for the patient at that point of time. So the removal of clot and the blockage is done by two methods. One is by giving medication to dissolve the clot, but this medication can only dissolve the clot. It cannot remove the cholesterol deposit. Or you can go with an angiography and angioplasty, which is more preferred because angiography and angioplasty, you can see exactly where the clot is. Then you can do some measures to remove the clot either by a balloon or by sucking it out and then put a stent to remove the cholesterol deposit there. So this is the way. If you have reached a hospital where angioplasty can be done, that is the best. Another mistake we do is once a doctor tells us that you have a heart attack, we think of going to another hospital which we prefer. Please do not do that because every second is important. When you travel from one to another, you will be wasting at least half an hour, 45 minutes. In that half an hour, 45 minutes, you might have caused considerable damage to your heart muscle. Do not do that thing. Wherever you are, if they don't have facility for angioplasty, take that clot dissolving medication we call as thrombolytic. And then after that, you go to another hospital. If you have an angioplasty, immediately without wasting even a second, go ahead and do that angiography and take care of the blockage and the clot which is there. I think this is the best you can do. And once you do that, you will be able to save a lot of life. Thank you.